sorry, Mrs. Davidson, but I thought you'd want to hear this immediately.
It's about the attack on Vince Talbot. It wasn't an accident. It was deliberate.
Well, I'm going to tell him the truth, Lizzie.
Oh, it'll be all right. He's always stuck by you before.
Yeah, Judy doesn't reckon I should, though.
Listen, all I said is that some men are funny about rape.
Yeah, he's a good kid.
Yeah, well, you probably know him better than me.
Look, he'll understand. All I have to say is that I got pregnant because I was raped. I don't have to go into the details.
Oh, brother.
You got to expect a few questions, love.
Well, what if he doesn't understand? What if he leaves me?
Attacking an innocent bystander, it's too much.
If he was innocent.
I've had enough. The women are not a law unto themselves.
Leave that and go inside, please. Attention, everybody. Mrs. Davidson wants to speak to you.
I don't want to speak to any of you, but it seems I must. Yesterday, a visitor to Wentworth was attacked. Your pretext was he was accidentally involved in a game of volleyball. As he didn't press charges, I was forced to accept this rather whimsical explanation. I have since learned that the attack on Mr. Talbot was both deliberate and premeditated. If you have any legitimate grievance, then I can help you. There is no need for you to take the law into your own hands. Well, Smith, do you have any opinion as to why this man was attacked, Bryant?
Oh, could say it was group therapy.
Very well. It seems you were all involved. I was going to punish only those immediately concerned. But if it's therapy you want, then the loss of 7 days remission all round should be therapeutic enough. Good morning.
Mrs. Jackson.
Group therapy.
Well, it did do us good at the time.
7 more days in the slammer.
Bloody K.
Yeah. Seems it was that bitch. Okay, from now on, it's open season on her.
Yeah, well, I thought you had a deal not to touch her.
I did. The deal's off.
Listen, you've already got 7 days remission. You're going to go for 14? Lee, if you so much as breathe on Kay, she's going to go straight to the screws. And you can bet she's already made a deal with Davo.
Yeah, in the mood Davo's in, I wouldn't like to risk another 7 days.
So we find another way of getting her.
Well, she's only got one weakness, and that's gambling. She gets in too far. She starts losing other people's money. It's a sickness with her.
You ought to see her when she loses.
You know, she's going to get her psychiatrist to tell the judge that she is cured.
Well, we'll just have to see that she isn't. Margo, you're going to have to give her credit.
In a pig's eye?
Ah, come on. We'll start a bank. Not a fortune. I want $2 from everyone who lost their work release because of Lady Muck. Come on, come on, come on. All contributions gratefully received. Thank you. Come on, Doreen.
Come in if you're good looking. Oh, watch out for the kitty tray. Not that he needs a tray, he's so good. But we can all have our little accidents, can't we?
Are you quite safe up there?
Take the watering can, will you, dear?
Do you need any help?
No, 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 I'm fine, fine. Now, would anyone like a cup of tea?
Oh, no, thank you, Miss Forster. Mrs. Birdsworth was wondering if you had a few minutes to spare.
Of course, she can have all morning.
Well, I'm afraid she hasn't got all morning.
Sit down, dear. It's just about time for Butchie's morning tea. Oh, do you know where I found him yesterday? Asleep in the filing cabinet.
Yeah, where he couldn't be disturbed.
What was that, dear?
I reckon my file's in that cabinet, along with me application for me half a day out.
No, no, I think I sent that to the department.
You think?
Oh, was it the letter I was trying to find? You did give me a letter, didn't you, dear? From your sister?
From me daughter, Helen.
Oh, yes, yes, I remember now. You wanted to see the new baby.
What bloody baby? I wanted to see my granddaughter in hospital. I told you, she's having an operation.
Oh, then we must do something about that.
That's what you said last time. Oh, Mr. Reed had his faults, but at least he got things done.
Don't worry, I'll see to it.
When? She's going to have her poor little leg done the salvo.
Oh, dear, then. We've left it a bit late, haven't we?
We've left it a bit late. I've never seen anyone in my life drag a chain like you do. You're slow as a wet week, you lazy bitch.
Oh, how can you speak to someone like that who's trying to help you?
Help me? You're more yak than yakka. That's what you are.
Don't you speak to me like that.
I'll show you.
Leave that alone. Oh, you just wait till I catch you.
I'll try. Go on, you couldn't catch a bloody cold.
Stop that at once.
What is going on here? We can hear you halfway down the hall.
I've got to see the governor, Mrs. Jackson.
And I want to see the governor about her.
What is all this about?
You know my application to see Josie.
She hasn't even sent it. And she's lost my letter to Ellen, too.
How did B. Smith take it?
She wasn't overjoyed.
Doesn't matter. I'll be out of here soon enough anyway, thank God. You just stay right where you are.
Don't get your knickers in a knot. It's strictly business.
I have no business with you.
Okay, talk to Judy. Want to lay any bets?
Not interested.
Oh, come on. Why not try something at Flemington tomorrow?
Like what?
Well, how about Sky Boy? You can't go wrong with Sky Boy.
I could.
What weight's he carrying?
Now, I thought you weren't interested in the GGs.
I only asked.
Wouldn't want to lay a bet, would you?
You wouldn't take it.
Oh, come on. You're into me for so much dough already, another few bucks isn't going to make any difference.
Okay. I'll stay with Sky Boys. What are the odds?
2-1. You call those odds? I'm the only game in town.
$5, then.
Thank you. What else is running?
Look for yourself.
I'm not interested.
What about Flight King at Rose Hill?
I said I'm not interested.
Just to show I'm willing, I'll give you 8-1. You couldn't get better odds than that on the track.
No, I'm not interested.
I'd say it's just a matter of time.
I thought Lizzie was all for Miss Forster.
Well, it seems that mood has passed. Will you see her?
Yes, bring her in.
Lizzie?
Now, what's this I hear about you and Miss Forster? I believe you were shouting at her.
Anyone had shouted her. Any woman who wasn't a Christian would take a flaming pot lance and stuff them up.
Lizzie!
Stone the crows, Mrs. Davidson. Do you know what she did to me? She knew that I wanted to see little Josie this afternoon before her operation, and she swore she'd get me a pass.
Would the pass be late in coming through?
Well, it appears no application was sent in.
I asked her days ago.
I see. Mrs. Jackson, would you get me Lizzie's file, please?
She oughtn't to be allowed the silly old bag. Mr. Reed would have got off his bum and done something for me. But her, oh, no. All she's good for is cats. She'll be all right in a cat's home.
Thank you, Mrs. Jackson. Now, just calm down, Lizzie. The last time you applied for leave was on your birthday.
And I never got that neither.
What time is Josie's operation scheduled?
3:00, the salvo. I only wanted a little bit of time with her, Mrs. Davidson, just to keep her pecker up.
I think I can organize something.
Oh, you're a trimmer, Mrs. Davidson.
Come on, Lizzie, back to work.
I ought to have come to you in the first place instead of going to that stupid old dill of an old cat-loving old idiot.
Miss Forster. Miss Forster.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
I've been trying to ring Miss Forster on the internal phone. Did she go out?
Well, as far as I know, she's still in her office. Perhaps the phone's faulty. Would you like me to try from here?
Thank you, Wendy.
What's wrong?
Miss Forster's not answering her phone.
Get a doctor quickly.
Who's been hurt?
Miss Forster. She's unconscious.
Well, where is she?
In her office. Will somebody do something?
Miss Forster. Miss Forster. Come on. Come on now. Wake up. Wake up.
In a minute. In a minute. Hello, dear.
Are you all right?
Of course I'm all right. You wanted to see me now. What did you want to see me about now?
It's nothing important.
Then why are you here?
Well, it's lunchtime. I thought you'd care to join us for lunch in the staff room.
Oh, no, no, no. I always bring my own lunch. Budgie likes me to eat with him. Perhaps you'd care to join me for lunch. Maybe you'd like to share my sprouts.
Sprouts?
Yes. Bean sprouts, carrots, beans, onions. Raw food, dear. It keeps one alert. I thought I might try it. I've been feeling a little bit tired of late.
What, have you been having trouble sleeping?
Yes, I have, lately. Touch of indigestion. Oh, I must say, I prefer them in soup. Would you care for one?
No, Miss Forster, I won't rob you of your lunch. I'll bring something back from the kitchen.
Did you see her?
Cancel that order for a doctor, will you, Wendy?
What about the ambulance?
You rang for an ambulance?
Well, Miss Bennett said...
Well, cancel it. Quick smart, really.
But is she all right?
You know, there's nothing like bean sprouts for keeping you alert, Miss Bennett. You should try them.
Well, she is all right.
Did you know that people who eat raw food don't panic like people who don't?
Could you stop fooling about? What happened?
She fell asleep.
Calls herself a social worker. She's mad.
You mean she's done nothing about you seeing Josie?
Nothing. It slipped her mind.
To think we used to bitch about Mr. Reed.
We was lucky, but we didn't know it.
How'd you go? She's punting?
Not yet, but she's nibbling at the bait. It won't be long before we hook her. Hope you know what you're doing. She could end up being into us for heaps, you know.
The minute she goes over the kitty, you refuse to pay.
Why don't you just let me bash her?
Bash first, think later. That's your problem, you know, Margo. If you're responsible for us spending one extra week in here, you'll regret it.
Yeah, but I don't know how much longer I can hold out. She welched on me, you know.
Will you turn the record over? You've already given her a glass hamburger. That ought to hold you for a while.
She'll go berserk when I don't pay up.
Then just make sure there's a screw around when she does.
Right, pack up for lunch now, ladies.
Heard anything yet, Mrs. Jackson?
Not yet, Lizzie.
Don't think old Davo's let me down.
She doesn't often do that.
I wrote to her, you know, and I said there's no show without punch. She promised me she wouldn't let them start until I got there, but I can't get to see that.
What do you want?
Settling in?
I won't be here that long.
Well, what a shame. We don't get many like you in here. When there aren't many who can wipe out our work release program with one hand and lose a 7 days remission with the other.
I gave you a choice. Pay up or I'd report you for attacking Vince Talbot.
Aren't you just a little bit nervous? I've seen people marked for life for less than you've done.
Are you threatening me?
Not really. Just putting you in the picture, that's all.
Yes, well... Just don't make a move, or I scream for the warders. They won't let you touch me. And you don't scare me either, you great fat cow.
Smith, what are you doing here?
She's throwing her weight around.
White, go and have your lunch. I'm warning you, Smith. The governor is in no mood for trouble.
I won't be here for that long. He'll be here long enough, you bitch.
When I was first in welfare, it was a different story. I've seen many a man hand his children to the department because he couldn't afford to feed them. They didn't try and keep families together in those days. They just shoved them into foundling homes. And if the parents couldn't afford to bail them out, well, they just became wards of the state, lost forever.
How long ago was this?
After the war. Oh, I was fighting fit in those days. I took on the children's department time and time again.
course, it didn't do my career any good. Girls half my age were promoted over my head. And now, all I've got to look forward to is one more year, and I retire. And you know what? I can't wait.
Well, at least you've used your life. You haven't wasted it.
Do you feel you're wasting yours?
Yes, sometimes. I could put up with this job when the wife and kids were alive because, well, I was doing it for them. But now they're gone. I don't know, I just feel as if I'm just going to work, going home, going to bed, going to sleep. And sometimes I wonder why I bother at all. You see, when the boys were alive, I had something to plan for, but...
But you're a young man. You can make a fresh start. And you can, and you will, as far away from here as possible.
Well, there's not much demand for deputy governors these days.
Hold on. Where is it now? Yes, the Government Gazette. Have you seen it?
No, not that one.
Yes. Oh, yes. Here it is. Barnhurst is in the market for a governor. A nice little quiet prison. Just the sort of place for a chap like you who wants to get away from it all.
Governor, eh?
Miss Forster was supposed to have a reputation, you know. A legend in her time.
They should have retired her years ago.
Well, she's still only 59. She's got another year to go.
So she's going to doze it away here. I don't see why the department should dump all this rubbish on Wentworth. That dovering old fool's no good to anyone.
Well, she wasn't much use to Lizzie. Well, either she's past her or just doesn't care. I don't know which. You seen what she's done to her office?
Yes. But I can't see that she's going to create any more problems than Paul Reed did.
But at least Paul was efficient. This one won't tackle anything more involved than boiling a kettle.
Well, why do we have to have social workers here in the first place? The criminals don't need coddling. They need discipline. Now, if I had my way...
I know, Vera. You'd string them all up by the thumbs. You going straight home after work?
Oh, I suppose so. Why?
I just can't be bothered going home to an empty flat. Why don't we stop off and have a couple of drinks at the local?
Well, I'd like that, yes. Thanks.
And so I showed him. I went down to the pub, straight into the men's bar, with the baby in my arms and two of the children clutching at my skirts. And when I said, where is the father of these two children? And his mates pushed him forward. I said, then why aren't they properly clothed and fed? Well, he was ropeable. He reported me.
Forster, Mrs. Birdsworth has been given leave to see her granddaughter in hospital. I have asked Mrs. Jackson to make the arrangements. This was your job. I hope in the future you will deal with such requests with a little more efficiency.
That Erica. She has a hasty tongue.
What time is it now, Bee?
5 minutes later than the last time you asked me.
Oh, Dave, I must have done something. I've got to see Josie. What if she goes under and she doesn't wake up again?
Well, there's not much likelihood of that now, is there, Lizzie?
Awful things can happen to little kids. Mm.
Lizzie?
I'm off. I'm ready, Mrs. Jackson.
How did you know you could go?
Oh, there's a big smile on your face.
Come on, Mrs. Huntley's waiting.
Doreen, is there any way it could be Kevin's kid?
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Maybe you could make him believe that it was.
He can add up, B. He's not stupid.
Well, you could make him believe it was premature as long as the two of you got together soon.
Oh, sure, and they're going to give us the bridal suite.
Paul Reed said you might just crack it for an overnight pass if you had a good enough excuse. Starting a family just might do it.
Mr. Reed's gone. By the time that old witch gets her roller skates on, the kid will be going to school.
Bypass her. Go direct to Davo.
I couldn't do that to Kevin, B. I just couldn't.
All right. But what's the alternative? Bypass her. Go direct to Davo.
I couldn't do that to Kevin, B. I just couldn't.
All right. But what's the alternative?
Where do you think you're going?
I want to see Mrs. Davidson.
You've been in here all this length of time and you think that you can just drop in?
I was going to ask when I found somebody.
Well, you found somebody. What do you want?
It's private.
Oh, don't be stupid, Burns.
Well, Mr. Reed said maybe I could get an overnight pass because I'm married.
Well, that's no reason.
But Mr. Reed said. Anyway, I want to ask Mrs. Davidson.
The governor doesn't deal in this sort of nonsense. You'd better see the social worker.
I want to see Mrs. Davidson.
You'll see the social worker or you'll go straight back to the laundry. Now, come on. Doreen Burns is here to see you, if you can spare the time.
What does she want, dear?
Overnight leave, which she doesn't deserve and shouldn't get, in my opinion.
Get me her file, dear, will you? There's a good girl.
It's not my job to fetch and carry for the social worker, Miss Foster. Burns, now make this quick and get back to work.
Sit down, dear. Dolly, isn't it?
Doreen, Miss Forster.
And what do you want?
I'm applying for an overnight pass.
Oh, do they give you girls overnight passes in this place? I think that's a bit liberal. I had no idea.
Yeah, well, I got married just a few weeks ago, Miss Forster.
Oh, did you? And did you do that on a pass?
No, in here. The governor was matron of honour.
Oh, she must approve of your young man.
Oh, yes, she does. Everybody likes Kevin. He's fantastic. And we thought we'd start a family straight away, and that's why I thought, well, if I could get a pass, you know?
A good idea, Dolly. There's nothing like a family to settle a girl down and keep her straight. How very sensible of Miss Davidson.
Well, what's it got to do with her?
That young woman who brought you in here, what's her name?
Miss Bennett.
A most unfortunate manner. Is she always like that?
No, worse.
Oh, suffered some sad loss, I suppose.
Miss Forster, it's about my overnight pass. Are you going to do anything about it?
Oh, it's up to me, is it? Yeah. Oh, yes, by all means.
Have you finished, Burns?
Oh, yes, yes, we've had a little talk. Drop in any time you need counselling. I'm always here.
Well, what did she say exactly?
She never says anything exactly. Nothing that makes any sense, that is. I think she thought I was just there for a chat.
Well, you're getting the pass or not? Oh, you two would make a good pair. Brains like suet pudding.
Well, I did ask her, Bea.
Well, if she doesn't do something by tomorrow and pull her finger out, I'll sort her out myself. Never gander at bloody muck over here. Bit short on for friends, didn't you?
Yeah, she's got her eye on Margo, though.
It won't be long now.
I'm back.
Oh, it's you, is it? I thought it was Sophie Loren.
How did Josie go?
Oh, like a little champion. We sat with her until she was took away. Then when she went, she turned around and gave us a great big smile. Then me and Ellen, we went out and had a great big dinner.
Oh. Nothing for you. You had your chance and blew it.
Did Skyboy win? Wrong time. When's his next race?
Saturday. You want to back him?
No, I'm not betting.
Hey, Kay, would you like a game of poker?
You don't mind, do you, B?
I don't mind. As long as she knows a jack from a king. No skin off my nose.
Well, I'm not playing for money.
Who asked you to? Okay, Doreen, have a deal.
Three sevens.
What have you got, Doreen?
Nothing.
Lizzie?
Things are crook and tallarook.
Oh, well, looks like you win again. I was getting dead boring. How about we have a few bob in the next hand?
No.
I'll be in it.
Yeah, count me in. You only live once.
Okay.
All right, but only 5 cents a game.
Oh, I'll keep tally.
What would you like to drink?
I
can have a scotch and ginger wine. I've never heard of that. It's a form of antifreeze. I'll tell the waitress. Could I have a scotch and ginger wine and a gin and tonic, please? There's Jim. Should we go over? No, I don't have to. Well, I think we should. He looks pretty bleak. Must be hell going home to that empty house each night. All right.
Jim, waiting for somebody?
No, no, please. Please join me.
We're just putting off going home.
Yes, so am I.
Well, it's not so bad going home in the cold. It doesn't take very long to warm up my place and then I'm set.
Yes, that's okay if you haven't known any better.
I may not have been married, but what's so great about it? You didn't exactly get on too well with your wife.
No, but the kids made quite a difference.
Jim, you'll have to get out of that place.
Yes, I know. I'm spending far too much time in the pub.
Rent it if you don't want to sell it.
Oh, no, I'm going to sell it. As a matter of fact, I'm thinking of moving on.
Oh, you'd be leaving Wentworth.
I said I'm thinking about it, Vera. You haven't got rid of me yet.
Been offered something better?
Well, there's a job up for grabs at Barnhurst.
Deputy Governor.
Governor.
It's a nice little place, Barnhurst. Have you applied?
No, not yet.
Well, you must. Jobs like that don't come up very often.
Well, I'm glad you think that I'm so suitable, Vera. What do you think, Meg?
If you can get it, grab it. Well, at least put in an application.
Hey, aren't you two playing?
We've been cleaned out.
Wow.
Yeah, she raised the stakes and it got too expensive.
Okay, what do you got?
Full house. Eights on kings. Your turn.
Oh, tough luck.
Yeah, unbelievable.
It's crazy.
Well, what have you got?
A headache. How am I holding?
Well, you're not. You've won seven and Kay's won 10, 20, 30, 40.
20 cents a game. I hope you're good for it.
You'll get paid.
When?
First thing in the morning. It's unbelievable, the card she's had. Okay, girls, let's call it a night.
Well, thanks for the game.
Four aces I had in that last hand. Four bloody aces. I haven't had four aces in 7 years.
I love it. Yes?
The Yank's in the laundry, is she? They'd send you too if you asked.
I'm on remand. I don't have to work.
Please yourself. I'd be bored silly. V sent this over. It's your winnings from last night. $11.40. You must have got lucky.
Not before time.
Seems a pity to waste it.
Waste what?
That lucky streak you're having. There's an interesting lineup at Flemington tomorrow.
Yeah, well, I'm not interested.
I thought you had a lot of faith in Cunnamulla.
Is he running?
In the 315.
What weight's he carrying?
Look for yourself.
Huh. I'd have more than that for breakfast. All right. But I'm not going to take lousy odds.
You got 20 to 1. I happen to believe that Cunnamulla couldn't run down a well.
11 o'clock and you still haven't heard.
Maybe she isn't in today.
Well, so what? Social workers are supposed to work a 7-day week just like anybody else.
You should have gone to old Dave, though.
I tried to, but Vera found me and shunted me off to Agnes.
Mm, that bitch had put a stop to anything.
It looks like I'm going to have to straighten her out.
Lizzie, could you take some clean towels to reception, please?
Right-o, Mr. Fletcher.
Hey, Mr. Fletcher.
What is it, Smith?
I want to see the social worker.
What, right now?
The sooner the better. Hey, Doreen?
Yeah.
All right, Smith, come on.
No, Butchie, this is not for you. You've got a nice, warm fur coat to keep you warm.
Hello,
dear. Oh, you're just in time for a cup of tea.
No thanks, Miss Forster. One of the long-term prisoners is here to see you. B. Smith.
Oh, I suppose I've got a file on her, but I don't want to disturb Butchie at the moment. Could you put me into the picture?
Well, she's in for murder. First her husband's lover, and then the husband.
Oh, dear me, she does sound a hardened criminal. Shouldn't you stay?
She's calmed down a lot since then. Smith. B. Smith, this is Miss Forster.
Hello. Sit down, Beatrice.
Beatrice?
That is your name, is it not?
I suppose it is.
And what do you want?
Doreen Burns came to see you yesterday.
I saw a young woman called Dolly.
That was Doreen. She came about an overnight pass to visit her husband.
Another prisoner's leave is of no concern of yours.
I just want to see she gets it, that's all.
She will in good time, Beatrice.
Well, that's not good enough. How about you have a shot at it tonight?
That's enough, Smith. How dare you try and pressure me?
I'm just trying to get you and your wheelchair on the road. You are supposed to help us, you know, not play with that bloody cat all day long.
You can tell your friend Dolly that I do not respond to scare tactics.
You wouldn't respond to a drowning man, you stupid old cow. We could rot for all you care. All you do is sit in here and knit and draw a fat salary and don't give a damn. Well, I'm warning you, if you don't smarten yourself up, I will personally see
to it. You will personally see to what? And you will not, I repeat, not insult members of my staff, particularly someone of Miss Forster's age and status. I am taking you off buy-up for a week.
She's not permanent, is she?
She retires at the end of a year, after a long and honourable career.
She's past it now.
The department doesn't seem to think so.
The department isn't locked in here day after stinking day, with its family on the outside, no way through to them except an old biddy who doesn't care. She is hopeless, Mrs. Davidson.
Compared with Mr. Reed, she may seem a little slow.
Slow? She forgets. She forgot legal aid for Kay White. She forgot Lizzie wanted to go and see Josie before her operation. And she forgot Doreen and Kevin's visit this afternoon. And that's what I want to see her about.
I will have her treated with respect,
oh,
Smith.
Respect? She wants respect. Let her earn it like everybody else around here. I don't care how crash hot she was when Bradman was a boy. It's what happens here and now that's important. And nobody gets on with her. She's no good.
What is the problem with Doreen?
Doreen's hardly seen Kevin alone since they were married. It's a bit tough on the kids. Mr. Reed was trying to organise an overnight pass before he left. A fat chance they've got to get one out of that Agnes bitch. You were matron of honour at the wedding, Mrs. Davidson. It's up to you to give this marriage a bit of a nudge.
Is it indeed?
Doreen was hoping for a contact visit this arvo.
As well as an overnight pass?
No harm in hoping.
All right, Smith. Go back to work. I'll see what I can do for Doreen.
Ta, Mrs. Davidson.
Miss Forster? No, it's Erica Davidson. Erica Davidson? The governor. Yes, that Mrs. Davidson. I'm ringing about Doreen Burns. No, not Dolly, Doreen. Mrs. Burns is entitled to a visit from her husband this afternoon. Would you ring him and remind him? You'll find his number in the file. I would also like you to process an application for an overnight pass for her. No, not this afternoon. It's to go to the department at once. Thank you.
Then Gunderman, and further down the field, it's Cactus Kid, followed by Vicola, Panorama well back with Brown Benny Rosencrantz, and lastly, Cunnamulla.
Listen to the races, eh?
No.
Well, it didn't exactly sound like kindergarten of the air to me.
All right, I was listening to the races. So what? I've got nothing better to do but hang around here getting bored out of my skull.
Uh-huh. Did you have a flutter?
What business is it of yours?
Oh, nothing. No skin off my nose. Just seems funny, that's all. You're making this big song and dance act to the psychiatrist.
All right, I had a couple of dollars on a horse. It doesn't mean I'm hooked.
Was it that money you won last night?
Where else do you think I got it?
It was all the money you had in the world, wasn't it? You know, that's incredible. You're going to get your psychiatrist to stand up in court and swear that you're on the straight and narrow. No more gambling. Yeah, I can just see it now. The judge will say to you, you got anything to add, Miss White? And you'll say, yeah, 10 to 1, you're gonna let me out of here. 10 to 1.
Don't you laugh at me. Do you hear? Don't you laugh at me. You just leave me alone.
My pleasure.
Kevin.
Now, stop that. You should be 3 feet apart.
Oh, Kevin.
Jesus, good to see you, Dor.
Any more of this nonsense, Burns, and you'll find yourself back inside.
Hey, what's the matter? You look like you've been crying.
Oh, it's nothing, Kevin, honest.
Well, something's been making you cry.
Oh, it's just because I'm missing you so much, you know.
Oh.
Hey, stop that.
But I have got some good news for you. Dave, I reckon she can give me an overnight pass.
Oh, great. Doesn't mean I can take you home?
Yeah, for the night anyway.
Oh, gee, that's great, you know. Because last time we only got the afternoon, didn't we?
Yeah, but it was all right, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, once I sort of talked to you to go and shopping, then.
Kevin, I've been thinking. You still want a family, don't you?
Yeah, sure.
Well, why don't we start one straight away?
Oh, no, love, it's not on.
What do you mean it's not on?
A couple of years, you know, when things pick up a bit, then you can have all the kids you want.
Yeah, but I want one now.
No, love, no. Not with business the way it is, you know. It's a big undertaking starting a family, and, well, when we have kids, I want us to do it right.
But I don't want to have to wait, Kevin. I can't wait.
Plenty of time for kids, love.
But we'd be all right. We've got our own house and everything.
No, Doreen, the house is yours, you know. It's your house. The business is mine, and I'm just keeping my head above water at the moment.
Yeah, well, we could go on the dole and I could get child endowment.
Hey, I'm not bringing any of my kids up to be bludgers, Doreen.
Oh, Kevin, you don't understand.
Hey, come on. Come on, give us a smile. Hey?
I warned you, Burns. No contact. Now get back inside. And I hope this never happens again.
You didn't tell him you were pregnant, did you?
He doesn't want to have a baby.
Well, I can understand how he wouldn't want someone else's.
I didn't tell him that. I just told him that I wanted to start a family. But he reckons he's not keen on me having a kid for at least 2 years. Oh, you should have heard him, Judy. He's not going to let me.
Well, that's what I call closing the stable door after the horse has bolted.
I can't pretend it's his. Not now. Oh, what am I going to do?
You listen to me, honey, huh? I think you should go ahead with the overnight night pass as planned, and then just go ahead with everything as we talked about. And a month from now, you just tell Kevin he's going to be a daddy.
Well, it's going to be on for young and old when I do.
Well, I mean, he'll understand that people don't always take contraceptives.
But what about the pill?
Well, you could forget to take it.
He knows I've got an awful memory.
That's a girl.
It's not right, is it?
My game, I think.
How many is that she's won?
There.
Are you sure that's right?
Oh, wake up to yourself. You didn't have any complaints when you was winning.
Add 'em up, Doreen.
Well, she's won 8 games and you've won 10, 20, 30, 40.
But we haven't played that many.
Yes, we have. 50, 60, 70,
and
80.
And you were the one who insisted on 2 bob a hand.
Which means you owe me?
$11.20.
But who's counting? Hand it over.
I haven't got it.
You ripped that much off us last night.
Well, I haven't got it. I've only got $1.20. There.
Not good enough.
Well, what are you going to do about it? You can't get blood out of a stone.
Oh, I can if I put my mind to it. Can't I, girls? Seeing as how we're all mates here, you can pay some of it off by giving me your buy-up. I lost mine for the week.
But that means I won't have any cigarettes. Well, that's not fair. Oh, damn you.
How much did she lose?
$11.20.
She did $10 on can of mullet.
Okay, hand it back to the bank. Come on.
don't see how I'm going to pull it off. Kevin talked like he'd make me take the pill and stand over me while I did it. Well, it's all right for Judy to say give it a go. She hasn't got any feelings for blokes. She could lie to Kevin, no worries.
I still think you ought to tell him.
Have a heart, Lizzie. She can't tell him now. He'll know she was going to palm a kid off as his. All that malarkey about starting a family, remember?
Well, you told me to try that.
Yes, but how was I to know he was dead set against the patter of little feet? It looks like abortion's the only way.
Oh, B.
Remember when Chrissy wanted an abortion? Paul Reed was going to set it up for her, all clean and tidy, in a real hospital. She's got to see Agnes.
I couldn't go to her with this.
She's a woman, after all. She might be sympathetic. Anyway, it's her job. You were raped. You're entitled.
Do I have to?
No, you've got a choice, Doreen. As I said, you can have this kid and go it alone, or you can have a legal abortion and spend your life with Kevin. I'm not one for abortions. If this kid were Kevin's kid, I'd knock your ears off before I'd let you have one. But as things stand, you've got to get rid of it. And fast.
You're Doreen.
Yeah, Doreen Burns.
Mm. And you've come about your overnight pass.
Oh, gee, you got cracking.
Well, that's what I'm here for, to help you girls. Yes, it's under review, so it shouldn't be long.
Oh, well, thanks for getting Kevin in yesterday.
Oh, we had a lovely chat on the phone. What a nice young man. How could a girl like you end up in here when you got a nice young man like that? Still, never mind. I'm sure when you get out and settle down, you'll make a good wife and a wonderful mother.
Yeah, well, we don't want to have kids right away.
Oh, that's very sensible, Doreen. I'm a great believer in planned parenthood. I don't believe in people having children when they can't afford them.
Yeah. Well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about.
Good. What is it, dear?
Well,
Well, come on. Spit it out. I won't bite you. What's the trouble?
I want to have an abortion.
You what?
I'm pregnant, and I don't want to have it.
Are you sure you're pregnant?
Yeah, I'm 3 weeks late.
Oh, Doreen, there's no way I'd recommend an abortion.
But you said that...
I said people should avoid having children when they can't afford them. But when it's your own little baby, well, you must make it welcome. Maybe it's come at an inconvenient time, but it's your own little baby nevertheless.
But I don't want it.
Oh, but Doreen, you feel differently when it's here.
You've got to get me an abortion.
Doreen, I couldn't be a party to such wickedness. I mean, we're talking about a human life, a defenceless, innocent little person.
But it's not a person yet.
It's a person, he or she is, from the moment of conception.
Oh!
Abortion, indeed.
Good morning.
Morning.
You'll never make a typist, Mr. Fletcher. Why don't you get one of the girls to do that?
Well, as a matter of fact, it's not entirely Wentworth's business.
It's private, you mean?
Well, semi-private. I'm applying for a job.
You're not leaving us.
I mightn't get the job.
Oh, well, it's not outside the prison service.
No, as a matter of fact, I'm applying for the governorship of Barnhurst.
Oh, yes, I heard the governor was retiring. You'd do very well in the position.
You don't mind me applying, then?
Well, I'd be sorry to see you go. We've all learned to rely on you. However, that's no reason why you shouldn't better yourself. I hope you get it. They'll work you hard at Barnhurst, but you've never been afraid of that. The best of luck.
Well, could I cite you as a referee?
Yes, of course.
You were a bit lousy with the dinner.
You could have had mine. I couldn't touch it. Can't they do better than that?
Ah, what do you expect? This is Wentworth, not the Wentworth.
I had noticed.
Well, that's why the buy-up's such a big deal.
Yeah, she'll be here any minute, too.
7654321 0.
Right on the button.
Oh, what it is to be popular. I suppose this wouldn't have anything to do with the buy-up, would it, ladies? Now, move back, move back. There's no need to crowd me. There's one for each. Oh, with one exception. You know you've been taken off buy-ups for a week, don't you, Bea?
Yeah. Right. I was ready for it.
Here you are, then. Oh,
And would the lady who keeps ordering a bottle of tawny port please wake up to reality?
You can't blame me for trying, Mrs. Jackson. I might meet some dill pot who really thinks I am allowed.
I doubt it, Lizzie. You're too well known. Oh, by the way, Mrs. Huntley rang. She said to tell you that Joseph's operation has gone very well.
Oh, beauty.
Right, now, where's Kay White? You know the rules of the bar, don't you?
I know it's my only chance to get any cigarettes.
Right, then. That's it, ladies. Now, don't forget to fill out your forms before you go back to work.
Oh, I'll fill that in. After all, we might not like the same brand of fags.
Come in, dear. You must be Kevin Burns.
Yes, that's right.
Yes, well, sit down. I'm sorry to drag you away from work, but I couldn't speak to you on the telephone.
Yeah, well, look, is Doreen okay? She hasn't been injured or anything.
No, she's not injured.
Well, she's not sick.
Sit down, have a nice cup of tea.
No, look, I'm sorry, I didn't come here for a cup of tea. I came here because you said it was about Doreen and it was urgent.
Well, it is urgent. I want you to give your wife a good talking to. Do you know the silly girl wants to have an abortion?